serotonin-melatonin pathway. Serotonin is manufactured from the base amino acid tryptophan. Tryptophan is allowed to cross the blood-brain barrier and then convert into 5-HTP. 5-HTP is then converted into serotonin. And then serotonin can be further converted into melatonin. Usually, when a person is trying to naturally boost serotonin, they take either tryptophan or 5-HTP to do so. Niacin is also helpful to assist in this pathway, as tryptophan and 5-HTP can degrade into niacin if the person does not have enough niacin in the first place. Serotonin is popularized as the body's natural antidepressant, kind of what gives you a lift. Serotonin is better framed as an anti-rumination neurochemical. People who are low serotonin typically present as anxious, impulsive, and obsessively ruminating. And since serotonin is the precursor to melatonin, they also tend to have a lack of sleep. Serotonin modifies the impulsive reactionary thoughts of the brainstem and amygdala. The brainstem has a similar capacity to that of a reptile brain. Reptiles act in ways that would be viewed as kill, devour, and rape. Serotonin assists in modifying those impulsive processes to diplomacy, savoring food, and courting. So instead of killing that person who thinks differently than us, our reasoning ability, with the help of serotonin, modifies this to diplomacy. And figuring out how that person is different from us, and possibly seeking an overlap of agreement. Rather than devour that chocolate cake, we may savor it a bit as we share it with a friend. And rather than forced copulation, we may instead contact a person we are interested in through Facebook. Sugar, and particularly alcohol, are toxic to serotonin metabolism. You may notice that people who consume lots of sugar or alcohol tend to be impulsive. Coffee and caffeine trigger a dump of sugar stored in the liver, which has the same effect. Sugar, alcohol, and low-quality carbohydrates and caffeine are a setup for serotonin deficiency. A study was done in California prisons by Steven Schoenthaler with the help of then-Governor Arnold Schwarzenegger regarding sugar. It was found that restricting sugar significantly decreased incidences of violence. Melatonin, which is our sleep neurohormone, is created from serotonin inside the brain. You cannot take melatonin and have it cross the blood-brain barrier and get the melatonin into the brain. The melatonin has to be broken down into tryptophan and then build itself back up to melatonin inside the brain. If a person takes melatonin and gets some benefit, this is a good sign. It means the pathway is at least functioning somewhat. If not, then it is very possible that some toxic impairment is occurring, and it likely will have to be addressed. This pathway is subject to toxic impairment from mercury, which we have discussed in previous videos on the above asset. When a pathway is blocked, taking supplements is generally less than effective. There are also genetic factors that can increase or decrease serotonin-melatonin production, which can be assisted with supplementation. Also, exposure to a chronic stressful environment will deplete serotonin. Stressors that can affect serotonin can also be any type of chronic pain situation like fibromyalgia. Serotonin-melatonin issues present as classic tell signs are ruminating thoughts, impulsivity, and insomnia. Other associated things that may have other causes are carb and sugar cravings and anxiety. To address serotonin and melatonin issues, supplement with 100 to 500 milligrams of niacin, 500 to 1500 milligrams of tryptophan twice a day, and possibly 3 to 6 milligrams of melatonin at night. Toxic impairment. Address any toxic burden, specifically mercury amalgams in teeth. Diet. High protein foods, eliminate sugar, alcohol, and simple carbs. Environment. Decrease exposure to stress.